Hey guys, so what we're doing is today is a good day. Today's gonna be a double hit day. So today I was 198.1 pounds, which is below 200 for the first time in many, many years, and it also marks 105 pounds lost. So I'm pretty good, pretty psyched about that. That's two milestones. And you know, just a good day. Feel great, getting a lot of work done. You know, I love my butcher box meats that I've been eating. It's easy to control portions this way. I'll just take two burgers out, make two burgers, I'll take a steak out, make a steak, some cheese on it and stuff. Just makes it nice. So what I'd also like to do is give a little shout out to my nephew. You know, in the last couple years he's put on a little bit of some substantial weight, and he's taken it upon himself to change what he's doing and change what he's eating. So I'm proud of him there. He's been doing good on it. And I know he's been home for a week for vacation, you know, vacation. And from what my mother tells me, he's been doing great. He's not perusing through the refrigerator all the time looking for food to eat. So I'm proud that he does that. And, you know, his mother and father are both small in stature, you know, height-wise and stuff. So he's not going to be 5'10", 5'11". You know, he'll probably be more like 4'4", 5'4", 5'5". So, you know, on a small height like that, you know, 30 or 40 pounds can be, you know, huge. So, and he's, you know, he's a freshman in high school. So to be healthier and learn to eat healthier now is a great, you know, way to get started. And he can keep that up through his life if he chooses. But, you know, I think it'll be good for his self-esteem and for his, you know, overall health and longevity. And my father and mother both have diabetes problems. So, you know, if he can avoid having those issues when he gets older, I'm happy for him. And I think that's great. So, I just like to say to him, like, you know, keep it up. Keep doing what you're doing. And, you know, if kids at school don't understand or somebody else doesn't understand why you're eating that way, they don't need to. You can explain it to them if you choose. You can try to point them in the right direction if you choose. If not, just, you know, you're not forced to eat what they eat. You're not forced to have soda. You're not forced to have candy and ice cream. So, you know, just do what you got to do. And, you know, and I tell him, and he's kind of taking it to heart to not rely on the scale, because it's not always an accurate depiction of where you're at. And I've had the same thing, you know what I mean? I was 203 for a few days, at least a week. But I did notice clothes fitting a little differently. I did notice my shirt a little looser. So that's a plus. I mean, my belt size is dropping. I had to punch a couple extra holes in a new belt I bought. So that's always a plus. And those are the non-scale victories that you see. You know, if your pants are looser, if your shirts are looser, if you notice your belly a little smaller. You know, a lot of people say that tape measure is a much better way. You know, if you measure yourself, your belly, your thighs, your arms, your chest, you get a much better depiction of your actual body recomposition. And it's true. You know, weight can fluctuate a little bit with water and this and that. And if you just ate or you didn't eat, or So it's definitely something, you measure it and you measure yourself and you get much better idea of where you're at. So, but that's just a little update on my journey here. I never did like before pictures because I never thought, to post my journey on YouTube when I started this in like July. I did start taking more pictures now. So, when I get down to like when I get down another 15 pounds or so, I'll be able to show you more of a difference between, 5 or 10 pounds ago and, 15 or 20 more, 10 or 15, 15, 20 more pounds, in the future. So, that's kind of where I'm at. I do have a goal. I'm just gonna, I'm gonna see where I get comfortable. If I say 180 and I get there and I'm like, well, I could still lose a few more, then I will. If I'm like, I like it there, then I'll stay there. If I think I need to, have 5 more pounds on, I'll do that. So it's just, goals are fluid because you think you know what you want until you get there. And then you can adjust your final outcome. But I'm just happy to be healthier, feel better. And you don't have to go into the store and look for the pants that don't exist. Because in men's clothes, when you go in, a lot of the like brand name stuff nowadays, 38 or 40 is the biggest you're gonna get, and they're more rare. It's a lot easier to find 34, 36, 38 than it is. And then when you get into shirts, now you're limited on your shirt size. Dress shirts never fit or look good, with your big fat neck and the shirt is just baggy in places and doesn't stay in your pants correctly. And so, and even dress pants, you buy dress pants, unless you get them tailored or custom made, to fit your waist, now the bottom of the legs may be big and they don't look right they don't look right with your shoes. And so I'm just happy that finally being able to buy like I'll be able to buy like normal looking sized clothes. It just make it easier to buy clothes, so that's kind of where I'm at. I hope everybody has a today's Saturday. I'm getting ready to go to work. Gotta go drop the dogs off at my mother's. But otherwise, I'm just happy where I'm at. And for anybody else on this journey or anybody else starting it, the health benefits alone, aside from any weight loss that you achieve or, come up to, the health benefits alone, the feeling, the good feeling that you get, the steady energy, the not dragging, it, to me is a benefit all its own. So even if you don't need to lose weight and you just want to feel better on a daily basis, I would suggest, looking into cleaning up your diet, the oils that you use to cook, the food that you eat, the sugar that you ingest. I mean, if you just look, if you do some research and look into artificial sweeteners and insulin responses and things, you'd be surprised not at the food that you think is good or you think is low sugar or whatever, and what its actual effect is on you. So, just things to think about. And otherwise, have a good weekend. Have a good day. Have a good week. Look forward to, to living and actually do it. All right, thanks. See you next time. Have a great one.